Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture on partial differential equations. In the previous class we have discussed about formation of a partial differential equation by using elimination of constants, arbitrary constants, and in the today's class we will be discussing how to create or how to form a partial differential equation by eliminating the arbitrary functions. Let's consider this equation. Z is equals to y into f of x plus x into phi of y. So here f of x and then phi of y, these are the two functions to be eliminated. This is f of x and this is phi of y, these two to be eliminated. At the end we should not have these functions. So let's consider this. Z is equals to y times of f of x plus x times of phi of y. Call this as equation number 1. And differentiate this one with respect to x partially. When we do that, we know that dou z by dou x is equals to p. So, p is equal to y into f dash of x plus phi of y, which is a constant. And then when we differentiate this x with respect to 1, it will with respect to x, it will be 1. So this is the P, let's call this as equation 2. Again, differentiate 1 with respect to y partially. So what happens? Dou z by dou y, which is q. That is, f of x into derivative of y is 1. So f of x alone we get it. And here x is a constant. So derivative of y is phi dash of y. So we have P as this and q as this one, and of these we need to eliminate the functions. So in order to eliminate that, differentiate equation 2 with respect to x partially and 3 with respect to y partially. That means 2 is p. P is nothing but dou z by dou x and q is dou z by dou y. If you differentiate this again with respect to x, it will become s, and this will become, when you differentiate again this with respect to y, it will become t. So let's see this one. So it is r. It is, when we differentiate this with respect to x, it will become r. R is equal to y times of f double dash of x. Call this as equation number 4. And when we differentiate this with 3 with respect to y, it will become t is equal to x phi double dash of y. We can replace these two. Again, differentiate with 2 with respect to y, we get s. I'll just show this one. Dou z by dou x, if we differentiate this, it will become r. When we differentiate this, same thing with respect to y, it will be t. Whereas s, how do we get, means dou square z by dou x into dou y or dou y into dou x. This is equal to s. That is what we have done it. So second one was already with respect to y, though then we will be getting this equation. So what we have to do is, we need to consider this x into 2 and y into 3. So we will be getting x into 2, means the second equation was p. So when x is multiplied, it will become px. Third equation was q. So when it is multiplied with y, you will be getting qy. Then this is nothing but px plus qy is equal to xy into f dash of x plus x into phi of y plus y into f of x plus xy into phi dash of y. That gives us px plus qy is equal to xy times of this, because here also xy is there and here also xy is there. So let us take the xy common, f dash of x, and then phi dash of y, we get it, plus x into phi of y plus y into f of x. So the first equation what we were having, by using that equation and then the sixth equation, replacing all that, that is x, y by s we will be getting, then this is replaced with s actually. F dash of x plus phi dash of y was s. So this part is replaced with s. So we will be getting x, y into s. And this part was actually z. So we are getting the required equation as this one. Px plus qy is equal to xys plus z. That is the required equation, we get it. Let's take in another example. That is, z is equal to f1 of y minus 2x plus f2 of 2y minus x. And it's given, let's consider this one. As usual, we will differentiate the equation 1 with respect to x partially. So, dou z by dou x, we get it as p is equal to, and it is differentiated with respect to x, you can observe here, f1 dash into derivative of this one, that is y minus 2x, if you differentiate with respect to x, minus 2 will be multiplied. So it is minus 2 into f1 dash of y minus 2x minus f2 of 2y minus x, because when minus x is differentiated, minus 1 will be multiplied, therefore it will become minus sign. So we are getting this as p. Same way, when we differentiate with respect to y partially, we can observe here z into f1 dash of y minus 2x. When we differentiate y minus 2x with respect to y, 1 is multiplied. So, no change will be there. And similarly here, f2 into 2y, f2 of 2y minus x, when you differentiate, it will become 2y f2 dash of 2y minus x, and 2 gets multiplied. Therefore, it is multiplied over here. So, this is about P and Q. Now, we need to eliminate the F1 dash and then F2 dash among the two equations. So, differentiate 2 again with respect to x, and as I told already that dou square z by dou x square will be r. So, this is what we will be getting it. And with respect to y, if we do, it will be t, and 2 with respect to y, or with respect to the this one, then s, that is actually dou square z by dou x into dou y we will be getting. This is the equation. Now consider the equation 2 into 6 plus 4. Somehow we need to eliminate this f dash, f double dash, etc. And we will be getting this. So it is a f double dash of, f2 double dash of this one, which can be eliminated from the next equation. That is 2 into 5 plus 6. It is like a simultaneous solving the simultaneous equation. 2t plus s is equal to this one we are getting. Again, we will be replacing it, or dividing the 7 by 8, we can get this equation, or cross multiplying it and simplifying it. 3 by 2, 3 by 6 will be 1 by 2. So, it will be 4s plus 2r is equal to minus 2t minus s, because only minus will remain here. So, we are getting 2r plus 2t plus 5s is equals to 0. This is the required PDE. Next, let's consider the other equation. Phi of x plus y plus z is equal, comma, xy plus z square is equals to 0. The given function b, phi of u comma v is equal to 0. Let's call this as u and this as v. That is, u is equal to x plus y plus z, and v is equal to xy plus z square. So we will use the Jacobian method in order to simplify that. That is, Jacobian dou u v by x y is given by dou u by dou x, dou v by dou y, dou u by dou, sorry, dou v by dou x, dou u by dou y, and dou v by dou y. This is a Jacobian. Next, we know that u is equals to x plus y plus z, and v is equals to xy plus z square. Let's find out the required elements in the Jacobian. What is dou u by dou x, dou v by dou x, and so on. So when we consider this equation, dou u by dou x, if we do, it will be 1 plus dou z by dou x, because z is a function of xy. So it is 1 plus p, we get it. Similarly, dou u by dou y, if we do, it is 1 plus dou z by dou y, that is 1 plus q. And dou v by dou x is given by y plus 2z into dou z by dou x, that is 2zp, and here x plus 2zq similarly. Now let us replace in the Jacobian. 1 plus p, y plus 2zp, 1 plus q, x plus 2zq. This gives us 0. And we know that Jacobian, that is 1 plus p into x plus 2zq minus 1 plus q into y plus 2zp is equal to 0. Let's multiply this now. 1x plus px plus 2zpq plus 2zq minus qy minus y minus 2zqpq and 2zp is equal to 0. Cancelling the like terms, we will be getting x minus y plus px minus qy plus 2z times of q minus p. That is, from this term and this term, we are taking the 2z common, then we will be getting q minus p. This is the required PDE, because we don't have f of x or y or anything. There is no function in this one, therefore it is a required PDE. Similar type, one more example. F of x y by z into comma z is equals to 0. So again we will call this as u and this as v. So u is equal to x y by z and v is equal to z. So we get dou u by dou x, which is y times of z minus x dou z by dou x, that is p divided by z square, and dou v by dou x is given by dou z by dou x, which is called as p. Dou v by dou y will be dou z by dou y, that is q, and dou u by dou y is z and y will be function, so x will be taken as a constant. So y by z, when we do, we have to do the quotient rule. So only one I would like to explain, either this one or this one. So let me take this one. How to do the differentiation? So when we do dou u by dou x, y is taken as a constant. When we take the y outside, product rule we have to apply, that is y by z, z into derivative of y, which will be 1 minus x into derivative of z with respect to x, dou z by dou x all divided by the denominator square, that is z square. This is what we have done. This y into z minus x into dou z by dou x whole divided by z square. What is our dou z by dou x? It is nothing but p. Similarly, for the second one, x is a constant. So we will take a x outside. Then it will be z minus y into dou z by dou y divided by z square. So this is what we will be getting. Dou z by dou y is nothing but the q. So remaining things, I think it will be clear. And we know that the Jacobian is dou u by dou x, dou v by dou x, dou u by dou y and dou v by dou y, which is equals to 0. And let us replace the values of dou u by dou x and all this. Then we will be getting the Jacobian like this. We have replaced all these values. It is equals to 0. And we know how to simplify the Jacobian. So when we simplify this one, anyway, z square is common as an LCM. Can be taken out and then transferred to the other side. It will become 0. So on simplification, yzq minus xypq minus xzp minus plus minus into minus it is plus, this one minus into minus it will be plus. So we are getting xypq. This xypq cancels with minus xypq. So we will be getting zyq minus xzp. In that z can be taken outside. So we are getting qy minus px is equals to 0, or only this much. Thank you.